Don't forget, no drinking today.
Yeah, can you send me the link
when we go live? And put it over here. If you want a drink, you just come off camera. Is that alright, BG?
Ramadan Kareem to everyone. It is our first home wad in the holy month of Ramadan. We hope that everyone is safe at home, and for those of our participants and members that are fasting, we wish you all the best. Part of our pre-Ramadan advice was surrounding the best time to train, and if you listen to the Q&A with Elliot and Jamie Simmons, you might have listened to the part where they talked about training during Ramadan. And the outcome of that question was the best time to train is the time that suits your own schedule and body.
So after a lengthy and detailed and somewhat interesting conversation with Fighter 2009, who is obviously taking the holy month of Ramadan very, very seriously, he came to the conclusion that for him personally, training after iftar is where the results lie for him. And my goodness, those results are there. He's a physical specimen.
We hope you're joining in at home,
hello,
Fighter 2009.
Hello, Bati. Hello, Mona. Ramadan Kareem. Mariam. Deb Oban is ready to get fruity. Dua. Hello, Dua. Vince McLean. Howdy. Bati. Ramadan Kareem. Shukran. Shukran. Lucas Benelli. Ramadan Kareem, everyone.
How is Marco?
Masoodi. Ramadan Kareem. Sultan Muhammad, Ramadan Kareem as well. Fleur says hello. Syrian Fadio is in the house. We've got Mutaz Muhammad saying hello all. Nada Alhabi, hello Ramadan Kareem. Masoodi, when can we shop from Vogue Fitness? Well, Masoodi, I will pass you to the man that will handle that question right now.
Nothing to do with me. It's all you doing the website now.
Steve Hayes, oi oi.
That responsibility.
Billy G 101, if he could, he would sell it to you today, Masoodi.
Masoodi, I'm just working with incapable colleagues.
Yeah, he's been working in isolation by himself.
Yeah.
Muhammad Al-Hamami, hello Ramadan Kareem. I believe we will be crossing for our first Ramadan home wad in 60 seconds. So for those that are training pre-iftar, make sure you get your training in, and then you can hydrate as soon as you finish, once you can break the fast. For those that are training after the breaking of the fast, it is our general recommendation to have some fast-acting carbs in a small amount, such as dates, to break the fast. Do not overindulge or overeat before the training.
McDonald's, Mendy?
If they deliver. Mendy's always a good shout.
Yeah, Mendy, very good shout.
Fighter 20009, I can offer free consultation until end of Ramadan. We do rely on our locals for the best advice possible. So thank you to everyone. And I think we're crossing live in 3, 2, 1.
Hey guys, how are you? Ramadan Kareem from here at Vogue Fitness in Box 2. I am Elliot. This is Jamie. And Amanda, as I'm sure you already know by now, but if you're tuning in for the first time, yeah, you're going to have a good workout, a good start to the week. So we've got some gymnastic strength and a workout today, guys. We're starting off the week hard. So as always, we're going to get warm, get limber, crack through that, and then we'll get going. So all you need equipment-wise today is a med ball, a medicine ball, and a kettlebell. If you've not got a kettlebell, that's fine. You can use a dumbbell. We'll show you all the options. Okay, so only a med ball and a kettlebell. Sweet, so all we're gonna do first is 5 inchworms with a push-up. So if we watch Jamie, she's gonna keep her legs straight, touch her fingers to the floor. Now, if you can't keep your legs straight, a little bend is okay. You walk out to a push-up position. Now, if you need to, put your knees down onto the floor for your push-up, that's fine. Keeping the body nice and straight, chest to the floor, back up to the push-up. legs straight again before you walk your hands all the way back in and stand up. Five reps.
So while we do that, we have a question from Syrian Fadio, who is asking a new lens. Syrian Fadio, actually the timing of day adjusts the sunlight into the room, so very good on picking up the picture difference.
Does it look better, Syrian Fadio?
Yes, it will look different, but it's the same. It's the same lens.
Does it look better?
Yeah, let us know if you like the daylight look or the nighttime look.
Good. So making sure arms and legs stay straight as we're walking out. Elbows stay tucked into the body as we do that push-up. Obviously, if you can go on your toes, go on your toes. Done five, girls? Sweet. And then we're going to go for 10 tuck hollow snaps. So how that's going to look, Amanda's going to lie on her back. She's going to have her knees together, but you're just going to relax your bum on the floor, but keeping your knees, shins vertical. Your hands are going to be on the floor by the side of your body, okay? All we're going to do in a nice quick movement is we're going to squeeze our lower backs into the floor, which is going to bring our shoulders, hands, head and butt up off the floor. Go! Good. That was a bit of a slow motion one, but it was still perfect, all right? A little bit more aggressive. Go! There we go. Perfect. Okay, you're going to do 10 of those, not on my count, but just up snap, hold for a second, and then back down, just like Amanda was. 10 reps. So even if you're really good at hollows, guys, hollow rocks, hollow holds, whatever it is, go in your tuck just for the warm-up. Jamie's pretty decent at hollow holds, but she's in a tuck, so I'm sure you can as well.
Salam to Majid Ahmed.
Salam alaikum.
And Syrian Fadio likes the daylight look.
Oh, Fadio, your opinion matters a great deal, so shukran.
Good, once you've done 10, jump up. We're gonna have feet shoulder width apart. Jamie wanted to stay on the floor there, a little nap. Okay, feet shoulder width apart, toes turned out slightly, and we're gonna go for 15 nice and slow air squats. So hips below knees, keeping that chest up. Try and look straight ahead, not at the floor. And stand up to the top. Good, 15 reps. If we're feeling a little stiff from the weekend, then just use these to open up those hips, get those knees and ankles moving, and just go nice and slowly, guys. 15 reps.
Mumtaz Muhammad wants to know about Kubsa before working out. Kubsa and Mendy, if you want to recycle.
Double dose.
Yeah, double dose it. Reem A, Ramadan Kareem. Masoodi says, in Christmas they have Santa Claus. In Ramadan we have Billy. Too much dumbbells.
Okay, guys, and we're going to go for that again, but we're going to change some of the movements. For this round, though, the inchworm and the push-up will stay the same. So inchworm out. If you can do the lowering phase on your toes, then watch Amanda, lowering phase, and then if you need your knees to do the push-ups, then that's fine, okay? But five reps, inchworm with push-up again. If you went on your knees for the whole push-up in round one, maybe do the negative on your toes and then just knees down for the push-up.
Masoodi, if Billy was my Santa Claus, I would be trying to get off planet Earth. Also, Vicky Croft says, hey.
All right, Crofty.
And then Batty says, if they're free, Masoodi. Yes, that's, yeah, because that'd be a gift because it's Christmas.
For all the kids watching, no, Billy Graham is not a fictional character. He is very real.
He's pure.
I don't know if he's the same as Santa Claus on that same bracket. For the 10 hollow snaps this round, guys, if you can, we're going to go arms and legs straight. If not, stay in that tuck position. So exactly the same, but if we watch Amanda, it'll be snap and back down. Now try and keep the shoulders and the hips off the floor the same amount, guys. Okay, so try not to do like a V-up where we bring the torso up too far. Try and keep it nice and even. We're just squeezing the abs so we're in that nice hollow position. Okay, 10 reps. Good.
So guys, as well, let us know if you're training pre or post iftar. Good. Nadia Almazuki, hey all, we'll join you today. Very nice.
Welcome.
You're welcome indeed.
Where is Fighter 2009?
So remember, guys, these are hollow snaps, not hollow rocks. So you relax at the bottom, you snap and hold, and then you relax again. So obviously for those hollow rocks, we stay tight through the whole movement as we're rocking. Good, once you've done that, stand up. We're gonna go for another 15 air squats, but this round they should be a little bit easier. Are you okay down there? You sure? Oh, that's all right. Good. If you're feeling a bit delicate today, like Jamie is, then that's all right. Take your time on the floor. 15 air squats, same again.
Elliot will probably be in trouble later.
Nah.
Also, hopefully you've recovered from the Fruity Thursday superhero workout, if did.
Apparently this calls for Tuxedo Tuesday.
Tuxedo Tuesdays.
All 10 of you that watched on Thursday, thanks. If you don't know what you're on about, don't worry, don't go back and watch it. You didn't miss much.
We have Majid Ahmed saying, before iftar, if you want to burn fat.
Okay guys, come down to a push-up position. And we're going to go for 10 pushbacks. So if we watch Amanda, arms and legs straight, hands and feet shoulder width apart, pushing your nose to your toes, and then back to that plank position. 10 reps. Nice and slow. Open up those shoulders. Open up those hamstrings.
It is a long question to answer, but El Sima, your thoughts on if training pre-iftar increases fat burning?
I mean, potentially yes, but not if you're doing CrossFit. Not if you want to maintain strength as well.
And potential output could be affected as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Like if you're just sticking to low intensity, then potentially, yeah, but you don't want to be trying to go too high intensity if you're doing it fasted, I would suggest.
It's a bit like me, low intensity and lots of Monday.
Yeah, there you go.
On Tuxedo Tuesdays.
And this time, guys, we're going to go for 10 jump squats. So we're going to control the negative, and then we're going to drive nice and hard and jump out of the bottom. So control, jump, and then land. Or we can do what Amanda's going to do, which is go straight into the squat again. Jump, squat, jump, squat. Okay, 10 reps. Good. Try and move fast if you can to get that heart rate up a little bit. Don't worry if you're not quite there yet. We're going to have another round of these, so just use this as the first set. Good. And then what we're going to do, we're going to use our med ball for the first time today. You're going to hold it just as you would before we do the squat section of a war ball, but we're not going to squat. We're going to keep the legs locked out. We're going to press that med ball overhead until the wrists are stacked on top of the shoulders, on top of the hips, on top of the ankles. So we're in one straight line. As we come down, we bring those elbows in front before we press again. Good, 10 of those. So 10 med ball strict presses, just to warm up those shoulders, warm up that overhead position.
And welcome Nadja to the live workout. So she says she used to do them in the morning, the Vogue Fitness workout. So welcome to the live portion of it. So great work jumping in on the live chat. We do encourage that. Say hello, let us know you're there.
Drop the med ball once you've done that. And with the med ball, you're gonna do 10 med ball deadlifts. So you're gonna stand feet in that squat stance on the outside, hands down to the middle of that med ball, keeping the chest up, stand up, touch the floor and stand up again. So we're just bending and straightening the legs 10 times. So all I want you to think about, guys, is we're not pulling with the back, we're just bending the legs, standing up, bending the legs, standing up. Try and hinge at those hips.
Coach Elliot, we have a question from Muhammad Al-Hamami, from Nadja Al-Mazuki. She wants to know what she can do without the ball.
Without the ball today. So you can do the presses. If you've got a dumbbell, you can do the presses with the dumbbell or with a kettlebell, okay, like we did holding it with two hands, okay, and same for the deadlift. So the deadlifts Amanda's going to show, the presses Jamie's going to show. Where what? Oh, yeah. Okay, so for this second round, Jamie's going to use the dumbbell and Amanda's going to use the kettlebell, but we're going to start that again, guys. So 10 pushbacks first. So nose to toes, back to straight arms. So if you asked about not having a med ball, don't worry. We're going to show the options without a med ball in a second.
Yeah, so she has the alternative equipment. And Muhammad Al-Hamami says, hello, guys, from Muhammad Al-Hamami. Hello, Muhammad.
Hello.
Hello, Muhammad.
Ramadan Kareem.
Good morning.
Halla, halla.
Waiting for a hello from the Rack Man. If you're out there, Rack Man, let us know.
Mountain Man, Man of the Mountains.
What's next? The jump squats. Yeah, jump squats again, 10 reps. So this round, try not to stop. Try and go straight up and down. Good, and really try and jump, get that heart rate up.
So at first there was the Ant Monk's Tuck Jump, and then there are now calls for the Saud Al Mazoui Climber.
Yeah, the Saud Al Mazoui Climbers, otherwise known as the
Mountain Climber.
Good, so Jamie's going to show you how to press, how to press with the dumbbell. Amanda's going to show you with the kettlebell. Okay, so as you see, Jamie's holding it with each end underneath the chin and back overhead. Amanda's going to hold it in that goblet position, which is going to be a little bit difficult, a little bit tricky. So if you've got a dumbbell, it will be easy with that. But if not, that's fine.
El Simo, Greenwood looks absolutely pumped up for this wad tonight. You might have to calm her down.
She's going to go for him.
She's had a big day of training and she's just ready to psych herself up. Don't you worry, Billy Graham. She'll be raring to go in a minute, won't you, Jay?
Come on, Greenwood.
Guys, we're going to go back to those deadlifts, but this round we're going to go kettlebell deadlifts if you've got your kettlebell. If you've not got a kettlebell, you can do what Jamie's doing, stopping at mid-shin. So hinging back, making sure you're still bending your legs slightly. Good. Still bend your legs a little.
Hello, Yasmin Al-Samadi. She's says hello in Ramadan Kareem, and I think one of your favorites is on screen tonight. Yasmin from Marina Mall.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hello, Yasmin. Right, guys, so if you want to drink, guys, you can. Okay, the workout is going to come up here. First, we've got every minute on the minute for 10 minutes. On minute one, 10 strict handstand push-ups. If you can't do strict handstand push-ups, we're going to do tempo push-ups, okay? So on minute one, 10 reps, strict handstand push-up, or 10 reps, tempo push-up. On minute two, we're gonna do 20 hollow rocks, okay? So that's 5 sets. You have 1 minute to do the 10 pushing reps, then you rest until minute two, and then you have 1 minute to do the 20 hollow rocks, okay? So we do that 5 times. Then for the workout, we've got 3 minutes of work, 2 minutes of rest, 4 times, and it is at maximum intensity. So you wanna go as hard as you can for 3 minutes, so that after that 2 minute rest, you can go again. And the work you're gonna do is 20 wall balls, or if you've not got a target to throw to, 20 med ball thrusters and 20 kettlebell swings. So for 3 minutes, you're gonna go 20-20, as many times as you can. Okay, then after the 2 minute rest, you're gonna start where you finished. So you're gonna have a total round score at the end of the 4 rounds, okay? If you've got any questions, get those into Paddy Hegg. We're gonna go through all the movements now, starting with either the tempo push-up or the strict handstand push-up. So if we watch Jamie first, if you've got a space on a wall, you are gonna kick up to a handstand position where only your heels are touching the wall. So here, only heels touch the wall, nice and straight, no overarching of the back. You lower till your head touches the floor and then push back up again. That's 1 rep, okay? So it's not kipping, it's not bum to the wall, it's nice and strict reps. Good, do 2 reps for me, 2 more. 2, 3, and rest. Perfect, guys. So remember, because you won't be able to see from there, she's creating a triangle between her head and her hands. So as she's coming down, her elbows are coming forward, and then as she's pushing back up, she's pushing through her shoulders, okay? So if you've got a chair, you could do pike handstand push-ups like we do on boxes in class. Otherwise, the option is going to be tempo push-ups. And that tempo is going to be a 3-second negative. So 1, 2, 3, push. 1 second at the top. 1, 2, 3, push. Amanda got a little bit faster. 1, 2, 3, push. Okay, there you go. So it is difficult, okay? So all I want you to do is 5 reps of whatever option you're doing, the tempo strict push-up or the strict handstand push-up. Now, if you've got your ab mat, you can make that height a little bit higher by using your ab mat. If you've got a plate as well, you can put that ab mat on top of that plate. So if you're normally somebody who uses a bit of a progression to handstand push-ups, we can do that. Should we show how that looks?
So remember, guys, any questions, drop them in the live chat.
So Nadia, just as an example, guys, Jamie's just made that distance a little bit shorter by putting that ab mat. As you'll see, it looks like her arms aren't even bending anymore. Oh, how lovely is that? There we go, rest, good. So remember, this is a strength piece, guys, so we want something where you can do 10 reps unbroken for time under tension. Come down onto the floor. whatever progression you used in the warm-up for your hollow snap, whether it was your tuck or whether it was in your arms and legs straight, I want you to come to that position. If one of you does tuck and one of you does straight, that'd be great. You do tuck, sweet. Okay, and then from here, keep in that nice tight position now. We're gonna rock backwards and forwards. So see how she never loses tension? The abs stay tight the whole way through. So when her butt comes up, her shoulders come down and vice versa, okay? 10 reps.
Abdul Sattar says he needs extra large MyZone strap. Sattar sooner will only be extra large.
Okay, guys, so that's what we're doing for the first 10 minutes. On minute one, 10 strict handstand push-ups or 10 tempo push-ups. On minute two, 20 hollow rocks. Okay, we're going to do that 5 times. Now, the other two movements that we're going to be doing, wall balls and kettlebell swings, okay? So the wall ball, Jamie's going to show us, and then the alternative, Amanda's going to show us. So you're going to stand arms distance away from the wall, feet in your squat stance, holding the ball like you did for that med ball press. We're going to squat, throw the ball to the target. Okay, I want you to do 10 reps. So if you've got a wall, you're doing that. If you've not got a wall you can throw to, we're doing a med ball thruster. So it's a squat, drive and lock out, and then come back down. Okay, 10 reps here as well. Once Jamie's finished, she's going to show you what to do if you've not got a med ball, which is going to be two-handed dumbbell thruster.
I wonder what Option Fighter 2009 is doing.
So if you've not got a med ball, guys, you're going to do what Jamie's doing here, holding the dumbbell in the front rack, single dumbbell thruster. Good. Make your way over to your kettlebells, guys. Feet shoulder width apart. You're going to deadlift that kettlebell up just like you did with the med ball. Now, keeping the kettlebell above your knees, you're going to hinge back, start swinging to eye level, do 3 reps. Notice how the hips are coming back, the legs are getting locked out nice and hard. From there, keep on swinging and try and punch that kettlebell to the ceiling until you've done 3 USA swings all the way overhead. Good. So for the workout, it'll be 20 med ball thrusters, 20 kettlebell swings for 3 minutes. But don't worry about that now. We'll go through it one more time before we start. Now all you need to worry about is the gymnastics. Any more questions, Pat?
No, other than Sattar needing an extra large MyZone strap. No, I think we're good to go. Any questions, drop them in, guys. We're going to go to part A. Remember, go nice and steady on part A. This is not the intense part. This is the gymnastics and strength development.
Okay, guys, so you're either doing 10 strict handstand push-ups or 10 tempo push-ups. Remember, it's 3, 2, 1, push, hold for a second at the top. 10 seconds.
Shout out to Deb Oben, who challenged me on Scrabble yesterday. She's doing
Three,
a fantastic job.
2, 1, let's go. 2 Australians playing Scrabble. That couldn't have been a very long game.
Very high scoring.
4-letter words only, was it?
Very high scoring game.
Good, so 10 reps, guys. Time under tension is what we're looking for. This is that strength section. Yes, Amanda is getting a pump on. She heard that the clubs in Dubai are open now. Good, guys, so we're resting for the remainder of the minute before we do hollow rocks. So if you finish, just rest. We've got 10 seconds before we do those 20 hollow rocks. 10 seconds. 5, 3, 2, 1. 20 hollow rocks either in your tuck position or your arm straight position. Good. So making sure we're not slapping onto the floor. We're keeping the hips nice and tight, the shoulders nice and tight, and all that tension is in the abs. Good.
Yeah.
20 reps.
Deb Oben responding to an Instagram story that was posted about my last competitor getting beaten 25 times out of 28.
Good, guys. So we've got 30 seconds rest. That is set 1 done. We've got 4 more sets. So we're going back to the pushing reps now. 10 seconds. Hit. 3, 2, 1, let's go. So we're back to the tempo push-ups or the strict handstand push-ups.
Jamie Green making the handstand push-ups look embarrassingly easy. If we had Billy Graham on Tuxedo Tuesday doing them, what would you think would happen, Elliot?
What did you say?
If Billy Graham was doing the handstand push-ups on Tuxedo Tuesday.
I think he'd be grateful for the tuxedo being too tight to get upside down in. Pac-Man. Okay, guys, into hollow rocks in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So 20 hollow rocks, making sure we're keeping nice and tight. So if we did arms and legs straight in round one, and now we're starting to slap on the floor, then we can go to the tuck position that Jamie's in. All this tension should be in the abs, not in the hips. Shouldn't feel awkward slapping onto your back. Should feel nice and smooth in that rock. Good guys, that's two sets done, three to go. Ten seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go. So if you're doing these tempo push-ups, guys, and 10 reps at that tempo is getting hard, we don't want to change the tempo, we just want to change the progression. So if we need to just put our knees down on the floor, just like Amanda did there, that's absolutely fine, okay? We want time under tension to get those reps unbroken. That's how we're going to get stronger, not by doing 5 quick reps, resting, 5 quick reps.
Yep, that's right, guys. Scaling is not a crime, so make sure that you scale as necessary.
Don't scale that Mendy, though.
Perfect, so Amanda just finishing her set off on her knees there, just to make sure the movement's perfect, and she's building the strength in those arms. Good, onto the hollow rocks in 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Good, so making sure, as we've said every round, we're keeping those good positions, feeling it all in the abs. Shoulders never touch the floor. Butts never really touch the floor if we can. Abs nice and tight.
And this week's programming is done by none other than Elliot Simmons himself.
Thus far, Paddy Castro has not had his way with it. We'll see how that goes along the week.
It's Fruity Thursday that's going to, you
we'll
know.
We'll see how that week goes.
Fruity Thursday's come under review.
Yeah.
If they're not fruity enough, we make them fruitier. And also, Tuxedo Tuesdays. Will they happen? Will they not? That's
Tuxedo
the question
Tuesdays.
Everyone's asking.
Yeah.
The people have been asking
Ten
all day.
Seconds.
Will Tuxedo Tuesday happen?
Can't we make it Taco Tuesday? 3,
After Ramadan.
2, 1, let's go. Good, so this is round number 4, guys. Good, so these reps should be getting increasingly harder, guys. Getting harder. Good. I 10 seconds, guys, then Hollows. Copyright free, have added some new tunes to their playlist. Let's go, 20 Hollow Ops. Good, make sure those abs are burning. Make sure we're not slapping onto the floor. We're going nice and tight. Good, these girls, perfect demos. 30 seconds rest, guys, then we're on that last set.
Going into
There's a significant lack of commentary today. What's going on in the studio, Paddy Hegg?
Making sure everyone's paying attention to the quality in their repetitions.
Yep. 10 seconds, is that what you're doing?
Always paying attention.
Last set, two, one, last round, guys.
Last handstand push-ups, last push-ups, remember, quality.
Good, perfect. Awesome work, guys. This is that last round. Good, so make sure the quality's there. We've got 20 seconds and we're on those hollows. Is this copyright free? Ten seconds. 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Final minute now, final minute.
Good, guys. I'll give you that time to finish. You got 20 seconds to finish those hollow rocks, guys, so I'll give you the time. Just make sure quality is still there. It's all in your abs. Nice hollow position. Five, four, three, two, one.